Hello, welcome to Jnana. Last class we discussed what is industry and its classification. So today's in the class we are going to discuss what is commerce. So the previous class we discussed what is industry. So industry is mainly concerned with the manufacturing of the goods. So whatever the goods which you have manufactured, the work of this commerce is to distribute the goods. So manufacturing, the industry is just the manufactured goods. So after it get manufacturers, the work of the commerce is to distribute the goods and the services. So commerce includes two types of activities, mainly trade and auxiliaries to trade. So what is the meaning of trade? Trade means buying and selling of goods and services. I'll repeat again. Trade means buying and selling of goods and services. So buying and selling. So now what happens? Whatever the goods which have manufactured, okay? In industry, as I've told you, industry main thing is they'll manufacture, they produce the goods. So what is the work of the trade? They purchase the goods from the manufacturers. Trading means purchasing the goods from the manufacturer and they sell it to the consumer. So trading, it's buying and selling the goods. So in the trade, they're not going to manufacture any goods. Actual work of a trade means they'll purchase or they buy the goods from the manufacturers, and whatever they purchase, they are going to sell it to the wholesaler or retailer or the ultimate consumers. So now the second one is auxiliaries to trade. Auxiliaries to trade means what and all the activities which are connected in selling the goods to the consumer. That is the meaning of auxiliaries to trade. How these goods are purchased from the manufacturers, to the transport, or like many activities it is requires, like warehousing, advertisement and all. So the supporting activities for trade is known as auxiliaries to trade. Trade means buying and selling of goods and services. So from whom they are going to buy? From the manufacturers. After purchasing from the manufacturer, it has to get distributed. And for distributing, it needs some services or it needs some support. So that support is nothing but auxiliaries to trade. Okay. Now trade is divided into internal trade and external trade. Very simple. Trade, it's divided into two types. One is internal and external. Internal means, so buying and selling of the goods within the boundary, so within the country, the activities of buying and selling, it is known as internal trade. External trade means buying and selling of the goods outside the boundaries. Outside the boundaries means outside the countries. So that is the meaning of external trade. Next, internal trade is further classified into internal trade. As I've told you, internal trade means buying and selling of the goods and services within the boundaries, within the geographical boundaries or within the country. So now it is again divided into first one, wholesale trade. What happens in a wholesale trade? In wholesale trade, the goods will be purchasing in the bulk. Bulk means in the larger quantity. So they used to purchase in the larger quantity and they used to sell it to the retailer or to the consumer. So in a wholesale trade, what happens? The goods used to purchase it in the bulk. So that is the meaning of wholesale. When the goods are purchased and sold comparatively, when the goods are purchased and sold in the bulk, it is known as wholesale trade. And retail trade means here you can purchase and you can sell the goods in the lesser quantity to the final consumers. So you have a wide varieties. In retail trade, what happens? You'll get an options and you'll get a choices of purchasing of whatever the goods you want. You have a wide varieties of selecting. So now external trade. External trade means buying and selling of the goods outside the country. So import. Import, what is the meaning of import? Buying the goods from foreign countries. So importing means used to purchase the goods from the other country. Suppose if you have, like in our country, we might have some scarcity of resources. So what we will do, we'll buy it from the other country. That is the meaning of import. Export means selling the goods. We used to sell the goods to the other country. So that is the meaning of export. Entry port rate, buying the goods for the purpose of exporting it. So say for example, few countries are there, they used to import the goods, and after the import, they not use that goods for their purpose. So after importing the goods from one country, they used to sell it to the other country. They are not going to manufacture the goods. What they'll do, simply they'll buy from one country, and whatever the goods they have imported, that the same goods they will give it to the other country. That is the meaning of entry port. Next, auxiliaries to trade. Auxiliaries to trade, as I've told you, trading activities means buying and selling of the goods. For helping this trade, supporting activities of the trade is known as auxiliaries to trade. The first one is transport and communication. Transport means here, say for example, few states are like, say for example, tea are mainly produced in Assam, cotton in Gujarat, and few places are known for their own products, their specification of product. But suppose if this transportation is not there, we would have not tasted or we have not used the products of the different states. So because of this transportation, what happens? Because of this transportation, the goods which are produced in different states are getting reached to the all the people. So transport, because of this transportation, the goods are getting reached to the different parts of the states, and as well as communication. So communication, it is an exchange of information between the manufacturers, between the retailers, consumers and all. Because they are the one who is going to give the information to the manufacturer. So, wholesaler can give the information to the manufacturer. Retailer can give the information to the wholesaler. Then, wholesaler can give the information to the manufacturer. So, it is also helps that what is actually the consumer's expectations about the product. Suppose, say for example, consumers have the different tastes. But manufacturer doesn't know that because he stays in some other state. So who is the link between the manufacturer and the consumer? They are the wholesaler and the retailer. These people exchange an information to the manufacturer. So that is the meaning of communication. Next, banking and finance. Definitely to produce the goods or to sell the goods, they need money. So what is the banks provides the money for doing this activities. So auxiliaries to trade means even they need money for buying and selling purpose also, they need money. So bank and finance. So banking, it helps in providing the money for making the trading activities. Next is insurance. Insurance means business involves various types of the risk. Suppose the goods which have kept in like warehouses, or the goods which is kept in the factory, it may get fire accidents or it may get theft. So in order to overcome the damages or overcome that problems, insurance are helping. So suppose in that criteria or in that situation, what happens? All the burden will fall on that owner or that entrepreneur or the proprietor. If they made some insurance, so easily the loss can be compensated. So that is why they made an insurance. Next is warehousing. So warehousing means it's a place where the goods are warehousing, it's a place where the goods are stored. So what happens here? Say for example, few products are seasonal, but it will be available throughout the year. The conception. So what these warehouses will do, they store the goods, and whenever the demand creates, they'll So they will give, they'll provide the goods to the consumers. The next is advertising. So advertising means giving the knowledge or giving awareness about the product, whatever the new product is entered into the market. So advertising is what they'll give information. It is very important. It is like, it is a main method of promoting of a sale. So when the sale, like in order to increase the sale, advertising is the main task. So say for example, we used to buy the product after watching advertisement because we get motivated, or we'll see that, okay, let us see and let us be, we buy this product. So in like, because of this advertisement only, it creates or it increases the sale. So advertisement, it is gives an information about the product.